everyone, this is Sonal Chhibber, editor-in-chief, The Fashion Magazine, content writer, Dubai Fashion Magazine. So today it's a very nice day, sunny day, and I'm on a date with whom you will get to know soon. So I'm here to interview a famous Bollywood celeb, and she doesn't need any introduction as such. Still, I will introduce her a bit so that you can guess who she is. She has been a famous model, reality star, television actress, fit mom, and an inspiration to all women who want to be fit and classy and shine. So let's hope for the best. Any guesses who she is? For the unknown, she got married in 2015. She's mother of two beautiful kids, and she lives with her husband and beautiful kids in the city of Dubai. So let's get to know her. She is none other than Dimpy Ganguly. Yay! Hi Dimpy, how are you?
Thank you, I'm good. Thank you for your kind words. It means a lot.
It's a pleasure to meet you. And today I want to know that you have been a famous actress, model, and a reality TV star. So what's your background really, and what's your journey has been so far?
Well, you know, I'm really a very simple Bengali girl from the city of Calcutta who was brought up with very middle-class values, and I hold them the dearest, you know, the closest to my heart. What started off as more of a health-related solution actually catapulted my whole future towards this industry, basically. So when I was a little kid, I had an eating disorder. Whatever I would eat, I would just throw up, you know. And I did not really enjoy eating. I would be a very fussy eater, and you know, I was very skinny. My parents got really worried, and then the doctor had suggested them to put me into swimming. So from the age of 3 and a half, I started swimming, and I went on to become a national level swimmer.
Wow.
Yeah, that's not...
That's something I didn't
know. Yeah, not many people know about it. But like all throughout my life, I have been a swimmer. I have been very active in sports, athletics, shot put, swimming.
Wow.
You know, very, very active in sports. When it was time for me to quit swimming, I mean, finally it came to a point where I was almost done with swimming, you know, and I was like, you know, I'm 18 year old now, and 15 years of my life, that's all I've dedicated myself to, swimming, swimming and swimming. So there came a point of time where I knew I was ready to move on from swimming. You know, from 3 to the age of 18, 15 years, I had dedicated myself to swimming, you know. And that's when the question was, okay, studies is one aside, what do I do next?
Right.
And because I was so active in sports, I was always very fit.
Right.
So it was like a very common suggestion that why don't you try modeling?
Yeah.
But unfortunately, at that time, when I was a teenager, modeling wasn't a very conventional option for middle-class girls. And I had to put up with a lot of fight with my neighbors, my own parents, my relatives, everybody. But I guess it taught me a lesson, how to stand up for what you believe, you know, how to stand up.
Which is very important.
Yeah, exactly. And what started out as a hobby, well, it finally paid off, and you know, from starting off as a small-time model to going ahead and winning Miss Calcutta, and then moving on to Glad Rags, and then finally into reality television. It was a hell of a ride.
What a journey. So Dimpy, it was nice to hear about your social journey so far. But tell me, how are you in real life? Because the kind of image we have in our head is like a Bigg Boss contestant, you know, controversial star, television star, lot of, you know, like celebs are high-end, you know, haughty. So are you that in real life or you are the complete opposite?
Well, I don't know whether I'm the complete opposite or not, but I am very much your girl next door. I am not.
That's refreshing to hear.
I really don't. I'm, you know, you would find it strange, but I'm actually a shy person, you know. Oh. So I don't really like to pretend that, okay, I'm someone and you need to be a certain way because I am so this person, you know. So I don't like it. I like to blend with everybody. I like to...
And that I can vouch for really, because I found her pretty grounded and humble when I met her. No starry nakras and no, you know, this and that. She was okay with everything. And that was a change to see, you know. Because in our heads we have these notions that Indian models and Indian TV stars are very much, you know, in high air. But she is the complete opposite. And I agree to that and vouch for that. So Dimpy, we have seen you participate in biggest of reality shows like Bigg Boss, Nach Badiye, and many TV serials of, you know, high, you can say, entertainment value. So how has marriage and motherhood really changed you?
I think marriage is the biggest reality show ever.
Yeah.
It is shown down. It is full of drama, emotions, comic relief, and, you know, real stuff. You know, so I don't think it's...
And so is motherhood.
Yeah, and so is motherhood. It's totally challenging, you know. So if you'd seen me enthusiastically participating in all the reality show, it was a prepping ground for me for my marriage and motherhood. So it's not too different.
Yeah. Really. So Dimpy, you have a young daughter, four year old. Rihanna. Okay. And a cute little boy delivered last year.
Just around this time.
Yeah. And his name is?
Aryan.
So how are you preparing yourself to manage two young kids and that too at this challenging time of pandemic when everything is closed down? So it adds to, you know, stress levels and responsibilities. So how are you managing everything?
Frankly speaking, you know, I have not known life any other way because, you know, from the time I became a mom of two, it's been a pandemic. So for me, this is how it is. And thankfully, we live in a country which is still open. My daughter doesn't go to school, so at least I have some time in the morning to focus completely.
That's the benefit we have in Dubai.
Absolutely. And I have that time to give to my son. Yeah. And once my little tornado comes home, then it's, you know, it's just how...
Battlefield.
It gets a little bit crazy, if I have to be honest.
Yeah.
But I won't have it any other way, you know. When I see the two of them getting along and playing together and trying to interact, it's the best feeling ever.
So,
Dimpy,
you have a flawless skin. And you are quite fit. So just share with our viewers your beauty tips for skincare and what do you do to keep fit?
Like I was telling you, I was very active in sports. So I guess it became a lifestyle, you know, making the right choices to eat food. Not saying that I don't love my ghee and butters and cream. I love it. But, you know, you've got to balance it out sometimes. And one thing I consciously avoid is white sugar. So I don't do that.
Mm-hmm.
Next is, I'm a big advocate, especially for women, I'm a big advocate, mommies rather, a big advocate for breastfeeding.
Wow.
Because I think for me to go back to my pre-pregnancy weight, breastfeeding has majorly contributed towards that. I still breastfeed my son. He's going to be 1 year old. And moderate amount of activity throughout the day and the right choices.
I once saw you were into bollywood
That's dancing thing. Fitness through dancing. So that was something that it's an Australian company who were trying to set up their base in Dubai.
So you think dancing also helps?
Of course.
So then, how responsible do you feel as a social influencer with, you know, zillions of followers looking up to you for, you know, fitness, inspiration, and all the mommies out there looking to her and trying to be like her? And so how responsible do you feel about your post, because you keep posting, you know, about motherhood, about your experiences?
I really feel very responsible, and that's the reason why you'll see my page does not have too many paid advertisements and, you know, things that are not relevant to me in my life as a mom, as a woman. So I think because on the internet there's so much of information that can be completely misguiding for people. And that's why it's very difficult for teenagers growing up and, you know, for young mothers, young women, you know, who are just
especially the expats who, you know, leave their home country and try to settle here. It's kind of overwhelming at times.
Precisely. And that's why I try to keep it real.
The page is full of your kids and family photographs, which is a refreshing change, you know, because you go on any celeb's page, it will be like they will be talking about themselves, or there will be paid endorsements, but her page is different. It's full of, you know, good advices, real advices, her own experiences. So if you have still not followed her, then you're losing out. Do follow her. It's Dimpy_G on Insta.
Thank you.
So Dimpy, what's your take on beauty and fashion trends in Dubai? Dubai being the fashion and beauty hub, there are too many trends and there is a lot of modeling happening, a lot of fashion shows happening. So do you really follow those trends, or you believe in wearing what, you know, suits you? And how open are you for, you know, modeling and fashion shows?
So I guess when I was younger, I was very experimental. I'm not saying that I am not experimental right now, but of late I found myself taking a little slow in warming up to new trends. As a mom, I have to look out for my conveniences also. Like, for example, I'm a breastfeeding mom, so I cannot be wearing anything and going out, because if I need to nurse my son, it should be, you know, breastfeeding friendly. So I definitely, this is one thing I love about Dubai, that, you know, people have the liberty to choose and dress and be whatever they choose to be. That's remarkable, and without judgment. However, I don't blindly personally follow a trend. I take my time to warm up to a trend, and then I find my comfort zone, and then I try to incorporate that in my fashion sense.
Which are your favorite brands?
Oh, my all-time go-to brand, if you ask me, is Zara. Like, I know there's something that I always find there.
Mine
that I
too.
Like.
For your kids, which brands?
For my kids, I do a lot of Next, a lot of Carter.
Okay,
one more thing I want to mention here is I definitely don't believe in brands for kids. I don't, because I want to give my children the childhood that I have received. I have not grown up wearing Burberry or Gucci.
How do we see you in the next 5 years? What are your plans? What do you aspire to do? And where can we see you? We are missing you from the
industry. You know, I cannot guarantee anything on my career front.
But you're open to it.
I am open to it, but I also have to warn you that I will be always prioritizing my family first. So the next 5 years are very crucial for my kids. I guess once they grow up a little bit more and they are more independent, I will have more time.
Yeah, true.
And hopefully I will still
and
have
still
some
very
glamour.
And you're still very young and fit.
Hopefully in 5 years I will still be a little bit fit, if not as fit. But I don't have a career plan at the moment. I'm open to things.
So you're going with the flow.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. So in this COVID time, there are a lot of traveling restrictions, but I did see your Maldives face sand. So how did you manage travel at this crucial time? Is it your kids and it was a family with your beloved husband, Rohit, and kids? How did you manage all this?
The time that we decided to travel, it was very important for us because we were holed up inside, indoors for such a long time, and it was affecting all of us psychologically. I was battling postpartum depression myself, and Rohit was going through stress with his work. My kids were, you know, they were just being kids. Yes. So I think after much evaluation of our, you know, environment at that time, we realized that Maldives is actually one of the safest places to go to.
Yeah, and that's beautiful. Very scenic.
Of course, it's my all-time favorite holiday destination. And we were literally transported to a mask-free world.
Yeah.
You know, and we had a very, very nice 10 days spent there. And
if you still haven't seen a picture of Maldives, you've got to see that.
On Instagram.
Yeah. Any words of wisdom to the new lot who just see the showbiz as a, you know, channel to become famous?
Sure. One thing I would really like to tell everybody out there is that it's not easy, guys. You know, you don't become famous or you don't become successful overnight. You know? There are millions of people trying to break into the industry, and if you really think that's where your passions lie, ahead of your education, ahead of your family, ahead of everything, please, please consider how much is it really worth it. What is your, what are the chances that you will actually succeed, and what are the chances that you're risking everything?
And you should always have a backup plan.
Exactly. And you should not, you know, when I was in Gladrag, Mrs. Wadia had told us this thing, that by 25, you need to make sure which direction you're going. That includes having a proper education and a career choice.
Yes.
Because without these two things, it is late for you. And you need to have education. You cannot go ahead without, especially to all the young followers that I have, I would request you that do not quit education, because that is what will help you differentiate, and that is what that will help you make the right choice.
And please concentrate on mental health, because fitness and mental health are above all things.
Yes.
Yeah. So thanks, Dimpy, for today's interview. This lovely four snacks and a candid interview. So all those people who have yet not followed Dimpy, me, or Dubai Fashion Magazine, the Fashion Magazine, do that. We'll be coming up with some exciting stuff, and this interview was in line with our motto to cover influential women, inspiring women who are taking their lives to a new level and inspiring everyone with their work and basically the way they live. So watch out for more inspiring women. Here is Dimpy and me signing out. See ya.
Bye.
Bye.